We have loaded a bunch of plants, different species, into Rhino using the landsdesign plugin. And based on these plants, you can compute a shadow based on the location and the time of the year and the time of the day. So you can compute a shadow here. But now let's see how we can actually use the LadyBug tool library, which is an open source tool in Grasshopper, to compute some aspects of these trees. For instance, the solar radiation. Solar radiation is it's computed in kilowatt per hour per square meter. It actually computes the amount of light that is received by a certain type of geometry, right? So we can here, if we do this analysis, we can reference these three objects perfectly in Grasshopper. So they're here. We can now switch them off in Rhino. So they're all in Grasshopper now, right? Grasshopper objects. We can compute a solar radiation analysis using LadyBug tools, which is this set of tools over here. And there we go. So based on this color grid, and here we see the legend, we can actually see which surfaces, which leaves receive most sunlight based on the orientation of the tree and its location on the plot. You could also reference geometry, like the geometry of some surrounding buildings, and run the same simulation. So the geometry objects around here, they are referenced in Grasshopper, right? And the script computes again the incident radiation values for these three objects with a slightly different result. And the result is basically rendering mesh, which you can also bake into Rhino, and you can then close Grasshopper. Oh, let's just turn it off. So you would see the impact of the surrounding buildings on these trees, if they still get enough sunlight or not.